Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel MiTutorials. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a slicer with predefined time periods which will let you slice the data with the click of a button. For example, when I select 10 days here, I have my visual filtered for last 10 days. Likewise, when I select 60 days here, I have my visual filtered for last 60 days. And you can change this based on your requirements and create a predefined filter that will help you slice and dice your data with just a click of a button. So let us see how we can achieve this in Power BI. Let's get started with this tutorial. Let me show you the data model that I have here. I have a simple fact table here and then a calendar table that is connected to my fact table. If you don't know how to create a calendar table, I will leave a link to the video in the description below. Do check it out. So let's start by adding in the visual to our report. I'm going to add a clustered column chart here, and on the x-axis I'm going to add the date, and on the y-axis I have a measure here called total sales, which is nothing but calculate sum of the sales field from my orders table. I'm going to bring in the total sales into the visual here. And now, instead of displaying hierarchy here, I'm going to right click and select date. Now that our visual is created, it's now time for us to create a slicer that will let us choose how many number of days we want to go backwards and display our data. For example, 5 days, 10 days, 30 days, 60 days, etc. So let's do that. Along with that, we will also create a calendar table that will filter our x-axis of this particular visual. So let's do that. I'm going to go to the modeling tab and then click on new table. Let's give it a name. I'm going to call this as comparison period. Let's start by saying add columns, and then within the add columns I'm going to use the calendar table here, and I have the start date. The start date here is going to be today minus 5 days as an example, followed by a comma, and then the end date. The end date here is always going to be today. I'm going to close the bracket here. And then the next argument here within the add columns function is to define a name. So let's give it a name here. I'm going to call this as period, followed by a comma, and then the expression. The expression here, this is going to be 5 days. So I'm going to type in 5D, which is denoting nothing but the 5 days. And then I'm going to close the bracket here and confirm. And now let's take a look at the table that we have created here, which is basically nothing but a date column and then a period column here, which is saying that this is 5D. So this table basically has two columns. One column here is for date and the other is for period, which will let you choose which period you want to look at. For example, right now it says 5D. But notice one thing, that here when we have said 5 days, we've done today minus 5 here, but it is displaying 6 rows here. That is because the calendar table accepts or includes the start date as well as the end date. So to limit this to just 5 days, what we have to do is, instead of typing in minus 5, we will say as minus 4 and then confirm. And now we have just 5 rows appearing in our calendar table. And now let's go back here and start adding in more periods into our calendar table. So to do that, what I'm going to do here is, since I will be using the today function again and again, it is not right for me to keep calling that function again. So what I will do is, I'm going to define that as a variable so that we are calculating the today's date only once and then referring to that particular variable again and again. This will help us in increased performance of this measure. So I'm going to call this variable as current date is equals to, and then assign the today's function to this particular variable. And then now it's time for us to have the return statement as well. In my return statement, I now have the add columns calendar function, which is now basically creating the 5 day period here. And to add another, let's say 10 day period, what we have to do is, we will have to use the function here called union, which will stack both of these results, which is the 5 day period as well as the 10 day period, in one particular table. So now I can just enter a comma here and then copy the entire section of this code, paste it here, and then today minus 10. If we have to create for 10 days, remember that the start date and end date is inclusive in the calendar function. If we have to populate last 10 days dates, we will have to enter 9 here and then change this to 10. And then let's close the bracket here at the end and confirm. Now let's go back to our data view and check what is happening. I now have 5 rows here for 5 days. I have 10 rows here for last 10 days. Likewise, we will start adding in more periods here based on your requirements. I'm going to simply copy this particular code and then come down here. I'm going to paste this, enter a comma here, and then last 15, I have 5 days, I have 10 days. Now let's add 30 days. So I'm going to type in 29 here and then call this as 30 days, and then come down, paste this again. You can keep repeating this as many times as you want. I've now entered all the periods that I wanted. I have created 30 day period, 60 days, 90 days and 365 days. And now I can click on confirm. Let's quickly go back to our table view and take a look at this. And now I can see 10 days, 30 days, 365 days, 5 days, etc. And now let me add this period here into a slicer. I'm going to add the new slicer here and then bring it over here. And now you can see that there is a problem. These periods are not in order. If I sort them in ascending or descending, this is still not going to work because these are strings and we will have to provide an order for them. So let's quickly go back to our comparison period. And at the end of the add column function here, I'm going to add another column. This time I'm going to call this as order by. Close the quotes here, followed by a comma, and then I can enter my expression here. My 5D is first order. I want this to be at the top, and then I'm gonna copy this along with the comma here and then type in this, and now order by 2. Repeat the process here for all of the periods. And now I have entered all the order bys here and then I can click on confirm. Now let's go back to our table view here. You can see that we've added an order by column. I'm going to sort the period column here, sort by column by order by. And now let's go back to our report view and you can see that we now have this in descending order. I can simply come back here and select sort ascending. I now have 5 days, 10 days, 30 days, 60, 90, 365 days. Now let me choose 5 days here and take a look at the data or dates that is being returned here. You can see that I have data here appearing from 10th of October all the way up till 14th of October. And now we will have to create a relationship between the comparison period and the calendar table so that it will only filter those dates which have been sliced by the period slicer. So let's quickly do that. I'm going to drag the date field here into the date field of my calendar table and then click on save. So this will basically create the relationship between the comparison period and the calendar table. However, you can see that the direction of the filter here is basically from the calendar table to the comparison period table. But instead, we want this to be on the opposite side. The comparison period should filter the calendar table. We will not be able to change the direction of this relationship from comparison period to calendar because we have duplicate values in our comparison table. So that is why we will change the cross filter direction to both instead of single and then click on save. Now that our cross filter direction has changed, let's quickly go back to our report view. And then when I select 5 days here, you can see that we are only displaying last 5 days data in our visual. And now when I select 10 days here, I have 10 days data being displayed here. If you want, you can quickly add data labels as well. And then you can also add a trend line if you would like to. And then you have 30 days sales data being displayed. And when you select 365 here, you have 365 days of data appearing on your visual. Now we can quickly format the slicer that we have here. Let's go to the format tab under slicer settings. Make sure the single select is on. And let's head over to the shape here. If you want rounded rectangle, you can do that. And let's change the rounded corners to just about say 10 pixels. And then let's scroll down to layout. Instead of grid here, I would like to have this as a single row. And then let's also reduce the size here. Max button shown. I want to display all of them here. And then let's decrease the size of this. I can turn off the title here and then bring this down. Let me reduce the size a little bit more. And then let's head over to the callout value section. Instead of 12, I can probably drop this down to about 8. And now let's head over to the button section here. Let's scroll down and the default state here, I'm happy with how this is looking. Let's head over to the selected section here. And I would firstly want to change the fill color here. I would like to change this to, let's say, this green color here. And then let me turn off the border. And then let's scroll down and let's add the accent bar here. I want to add the accent bar at the bottom. And let's change the color here to this orange color here and then increase the width maybe to, let's say, about 5 pixels here. And if you want to change the way how these buttons interact when you hover over them, let's quickly change over to hover here, apply settings to hover, and then let's change the fill icon here to, let's say, this darker shade of gray. And then let's also turn off the border here. When you hover over them, you have this nice little effect here. And then let's also scroll up. Let's go to the callout values here on the hover state. And I want to make them bold. When I hover over them, you see that they are now bold. Let me increase the size of this visual so that I can accommodate the 365 days as well when it becomes bold. And now you can see that it's looking nice. When I hover over them, it becomes bold and this color changes as well. When I select 60 days here, I have a different color applied. I have the accent bar and then I have the visual here changing the number of days based on the selection that I make from this particular slicer. So this was the tutorial on how to display custom periods on your visual so that you can quickly select the different time periods based on your requirements. So that's it guys in this particular tutorial. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. You've learned something new today. Please consider subscribing to my channel for more such tutorials.